I'm studying both behavioral and neural aspects of development in songbirds specifically, and I'm studying which factors are influencing this learning process to see if this can explain individual differences between different songbirds, because just like infants, we have infants that learn to speak pretty quickly, easily. Most infants do actually pretty automatically, but there's also a group of infants that doesn't learn that easily and has a bit more trouble with that. And this is sort of a continuum, basically, so there's not a fixed line between those two. And you can see the same in the zebra finches. There's a continuum of good learners and poor learners and anything in between, and I'm looking for which factors influence that process. Well, one of the important aspects of youth, of development, is the development of language, of course. There is a critical period for learning, or at least a sensitive phase in which we young children are much better at learning languages. And at a certain point, for instance, it's not after your 20th or something, it's not really possible to really learn another language as your as good as your native language. The young period early in life is very important for language and speech learning. This is the interesting period where we're making the comparisons with birdsong. So that's why there's the important link with human development as well. For this research, there are two important goals. One is the more fundamental goal: how does everything work? How does the brain work during development? And what are all those different influences? And with that fundamental goal, we can actually use that for our more applied goal, and that's to help children with speech development issues. So there is a group of children that doesn't learn to speak that well, and is a very diverse group, and it's very difficult to know what is actually driving, what's the cause of their problems. And the research with animals, for instance, can help to figure it out, because we have a much more controlled setting and we can do these experiments in. I think it's really nice to see that people are coming together and trying from different perspectives to solve one big puzzle of development, because there are so many influences and you need all these different expertises to really figure out how a child develops, how the mechanism of development works.